Have an update from Marion County authorities on evacuations there. Scotts Mills evacuation was downgraded from a level 2 to a level 1. They tell us there are no changes in the other evacuation levels. Detroit, Idana, Brighton Bush, Mill City, and Gates are under level 3 evacuations. Also, Highway 22 east of Highway 226 and north of North Fork Road along Highway 22.
We are getting a better understanding of the damage the Beechey Creek fire has inflicted on Marion County communities. 470 homes were destroyed and 35 businesses are gone. And the fire also destroyed another 783 sheds, barns, and other structures. Another 46 homes plus 5 businesses were damaged in some way.
Cor Harlan joins us live along Highway 22 in Marion County now.
Yeah, Cor, what's the latest on the Beechey Creek fire?
Well, we're at the roadblock here at 226 and Highway 22 here in Mahama here, as we have been for the last several mornings. Are you talking about the damage figures there? Yesterday from Marion County Commissioner Kevin Cameron, we heard who actually has a residence in Detroit. His house was one of the few on his street that remained standing in the wake of the fire. But he described in terms of buildings and structures damaged out of about a little over 400 commercial and residential buildings in and around Detroit there. He said that there were about 250 of them that were destroyed. So the magnitude of the damage and structural damage is beginning to set in, and we're beginning to put some numbers on a lot of that stuff as well. And in the coming days, that'll be a pretty staggering amount to come up with. Of note also, the latest information, if you weren't here yesterday morning, we had a briefing from Marion County Commissioners, the Marion County Sheriff as well, and describing the scope of some of the work to be done here to repair all the infrastructure that has been damaged. We understand that the towns of Detroit and Gates are both without water as a result of fire damage to the municipal water system there. That will be one of the first priorities to put in place as well. A lot of utility lines and power lines that were in the path of the fire, for all intents and purposes, are probably melted and down on the ground. There have been a lot of utility crews up here. We expect to see them back up here within the next hour this morning here at the roadblock as well. I want to talk a little bit about perhaps the end of this, what seems like an endless air inversion over the Beechey Creek fire that again remains at around 192,000 acres. And acreage figures really have not changed that much over the last 6 days or so as a result of the inversion, the sort of the lid that the weather, the atmosphere has kind of put on this fire. And it has sort of burned in its own footprint for the last several days. That could be changing here within the next 24 to 36 hours. I was reading Natasha Stenbach's night note that she left for us before she went home last night there. And there is some discussion of rain in the forecast for Thursday and Friday, and possibly some thunderstorms as well. So there's a good side and there's a bad side to all of that that we will keep an eye out on. Of course, the good news is some of the breeze out of the south might mix up the atmosphere and blow a lot of this smoke out here and put some rain on the ground. That would help moisten up some of the fuels that are really bone dry out here. But the other thing as well is the lightning strikes. Those are could be potentially a problem if they happen in some places, and that wind could stir some embers back up. So we will see how that plays out there, how much wind accompanies the rain that is in the forecast. We'll just have to wait and see, Jenny and Ken, but I tell you what, a lot of folks would like to see the horizon and breathe a breath of fresh air in this part of the country, in this part of the state here anyway, as this inversion keeps the clouds and the smoke close to the ground here from the Beechey Creek fire this morning. We'll look for some rain in the forecast and hope that all goes well as we proceed from there.
Yeah, fingers crossed for rain, but maybe no lightning. Yeah. Thank you, Cor, for that update.